Hello students, I am Tonmo. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry and History of Molecules. So today we will discuss another name reaction, that is Beckmann Rearrangement. But we will discuss today on specifically aldehyde to nitrile conversion. There is another part of Beckmann, that is ketone to amide. So we will discuss in the next video. So today's lecture will cover few points, for example basic concept and mechanism associated with this aldehyde to nitrile conversion. Role of ethyl reagent, one step formation, actually say two step. So is it possible to carry out everything in one step? And finally the examples. Okay, let's start. As you can see that this is a carbonyl group, this is an aldehyde, means carbonyl reacting with hydroxylamine to produce finally this oxime and second acid treatment. So mention everything step by step. So the background concept is that actually you can see this is a carbon oxygen double bond and hydrogen. In next step what is happening? Actually it's a dehydration you may consider. I'll explain how it's happening. And second, so first step is the sheet-based condensation and second step is acid-catalyzed dehydration, because the ultimately this group weight is not a good leaving group. In order to make it good leaving group, these acids are used. Okay, so this is the overview. Let's start. So first step, this RCO, this aldehyde, first reacted with this hydroxylamine hydrochloride. Actual reagent is hydrochloride, just not this. Okay, even not only hydrochloride, there are some other reaction, for example hydrogen, hydroxylamine, bisulfate, etc. also there. So generally we will focus on this hydrochloride part, not this one. So why this is remains in hydrochloride salt? There is actually reason, this lone pair repulsion, this reagent is unstable and prone to oxidation. I'll discuss this thing in another video in details where you have a completion. Just focus on this. So what happens? That this attacks and prepares the oxime. So remember the sheet base. Of hydroxylamine called oxime. Okay, so this oxime is produced and this is the oxime. And in the second step what happens? In presence of acid, if you put acid, there are two, so actually chances that this nitrogen may be protonated, this oxygen, both are possible. But what happens, for in order to execute the reaction it is. So what I am saying that among two, there are two possible chances. This chance will result in the nitrile formation and this protonation actually is a reversible reaction. So if it is reversible and one part of this reversible reaction is resulting into a product, then the reaction will proceed in that way. And another thing, this elimination, it is better to indicate or show this elimination in an anti-direction. Why? I'll explain. So let's H plus, actually I previously missed it, this side H plus is not a right thing. So here OH2 plus. So what happened? So in presence of slight amount of heat, it attacks. This proton is abstracted, it goes and it leaves. So what it resulted? It resulted R triple bond CN plus, here water is left, so minus water, sorry, plus water and base H plus. This is produced. Okay, so this is a elimination step. So first step is addition elimination, this is the elimination. Now see, here is a double bond and this double bond is nothing but the double bond of this, and see this is converted into a triple bond. This is the basic part. Now, and actually this is the mechanism also. Okay, so always keep it in mind that oxime formation, oxime, I shall explain this in next video, oxime formation is
prefer to carry out under slightly acidic condition. Because first step,
if you provide too strong acid, then it will be protonated, so nucleophilic attack will not happen. If you provide too much base, then second step dehydration will not happen. Let me give you some brief thing. So first, this is attacks. Slightly acidic means it's protonated. It opens. So these results are COH. This is H. This is NH2+. Since after attack, this is the OH. Fine. So in second step, what will happen? One hydrogen will be eliminated in order to neutralize the molecule. Fine. And after that, now see, there are two hydroxyl. You may argue which will leave. Actually, these will leave. Because if it leaves, then positive charge will come on nitrogen. What do I mean? Okay. Let me clean this part. So, another option, what I am discussing, that for example, if this is protonated, then it will leave, then the positive charge will come OH, NH+, then proton will eliminate from here. That's not a favorable process because positive charge on electronegative nitrogen. In contrast, what happens if this is protonated? So let's clean it. This is protonated and it leaves. Then the positive charge is on the carbon, relatively more stable, NH, OH. And next step, what happened? Actually, nitrogen has a lone pair. So this positive charge could be resonance stabilized. It will come here. And in this way, see, this is H, this is the NH having plus charge plus OH. Fine. And since in this structure you can see all the atoms are octet filled. All are octet filled. So stabilized. In second step, this proton will be abstracted by base to have neutralized the molecule, which will result ultimately this one. Okay, so this is actually C-based reaction, and in this way, means through dehydration, through the first step, so this is the dehydration step minus water. So through the dehydration ultimately results in this C-based formation. Okay, so this is. Now role of each reagent, if we think, this is an aldehyde, this is an electrophile, this is an electrophile, hydroxylamine, it's a nucleophile, it's HCl salt is one. We should always write along with hydrogen and hydroxylamine, hydrochloride, sodium acetate, acetic acid, because it acts as a buffer and pH around 6 means slightly acidic. So it's a buffer solution. Buffer means a constant pH solution. So this, and such that this reaction carried out under the acidic medium. So we have discussed the first part of this process. Means the oxime formation. Okay, this. Now let's consider on the second part, means acid-trick catalyzed. We can say, okay, I have explained that part also, but I have to provide some other, for example, one step conversion. So, what we have learned? We have learned that this conversion, this aldehyde to this, for two-step is essential. Two-step essential means, first one step is this hydroxylamine-mediated oxime formation, second acid. But can we combine these two? Yes, it is possible. How? If we take this aldehyde and react this with, for example, hydroxylamine hydrochloride, actually this is commercially available as a salt, along with that, if we take formic acid, sodium formate, NaOOCH. This is the minus, this is the plus. So what happens? See, this is a hydrochloric acid salt, means acid salt. So and here we have taken this formic acid. So this hydroxylamine hydrochloride plus sodium acid. So what it will result? It will result hydroxylamine plus, see, this is HCl, this is sodium salt. So this sodium will react with this chloride to form sodium chloride. Ionic compound, stable, fine. And another thing, what is remaining? Formic acid. HCOOH. So in reactive medium, acid is generated. Okay. Now what's it? This is a strong acid. This is a strong acid. And this is weak acid. So this forward reaction is not thermodynamically unfavorable. So reaction will be carried out. Okay. So let's discuss this example step by step. So what happens? So in this case, after reaction, so I'm not just actually you may think that why I am writing, actually since it's one step, but still I shall write step by step such that you can understand the process little better way. Means, so formic acid, this thing, so what does this reaction means? This reaction generates free hydroxyl amine, fine, and when it generates, it will react with this to form oxime, RCONH OH. This I am writing anti, so I will explain another part. So hydroxylamine, and second step, what happens, there is in the reaction medium acid, so this S will be converted into ester. This OCOH, this is nothing but formate ester, and we should write this is formic acid, and in this way water is eliminated, and this is formate ester. Okay, so what happens in next step? There are some formate anion, because sodium formate we have used, so this formate can act as a base. Why I am saying this? Because you know acetic acid, what do I mean? This acetic acid you have learned a lot. This is not a good leaving group, not a good base. Okay, it's an in-between, borderline case. So what happens? This formic acid can abstract this, it will come this and it will leave. So here formate is at consumed, here formate is regenerated. So overall nothing changes. So, and this, and why, as in case of acetate, if you consider this is a hydrogen, so this is resonance stabilized, that's why this will leave. So, this will come here and it will come here. So, in this way, what is ultimately produced? This is ultimately produced RCN. RCN. Fine. So, another example. So, compared to that, if we use the hydroxylamine derivative of sulfuric acid, what do I mean? So you know sulfuric acid, and it has a derivative of, it could be converted into chlorosulfuric acid, that is also available commercially. So, and in the, by the way, I want to mention that if any acid having strength higher than sulfuric acid, that is considered as super acid. Okay. In this context, I have already made a video about super acid. Please go through that. Then you can understand this property better. So, fine. So, in this case, what is taken? Previously, this hydrazine and leaving group, both are separated. Separate reagent. So, ultimately, during the reaction mixture, they have combined and ultimately result is nitrile. Now, the concept is, instead of this, let's take the combination. Okay? And how that is done using the hydroxylamine derivative of sulfuric acid. So, actually the reagent looks like, so NHO this. Okay? So,
is it visible?
By the way, please don't be confused about this. I'll explain why. But generally, we think sulfur is there, so there will be a bond between nitrogen and sulfur. No, there is no bond with. The bond is between sulfuric acid and this. So you can consider this as a hydroxylamine derivative of chlorosulfuric acid. Those things. So sulfuric acid, okay, better to say sulfuric acid derivative. So what happens? See, and this reagent, this is more stable than simple hydroxylamine. Why? Because these lone pair, which because these and these having a strong repulsion, which you consider as an alpha effect, right now because of the presence of these two sulfuric acid, these two group. So this lone pair is stabilized by resonance using these two group. Fine. So this is stabilized and this is sulfuric acid. And so acid part, this is the acid part. As we told that this reaction is better under slightly acidic medium. So this is the acid part and this is the nucleophilic part. Okay. So it's a neutral nucleophile. So this reaction first, this is protonated in presence of this acid. Fine. Means better to say O minus H plus. Fine. Second step, these attacks. So what it produces? R COOH 2 plus this. This is the hydrogen and this is NH2 plus and oxygen is double bond O minus. Now this will be abstracted in equilibrium, so this proton could be abstracted. And another thing, now the interesting thing is that, so this, and if a proton previous, right, I made mistake, it should be OH, so neutralized. Now so the proton abstracted by this could be abstracted by this molecule and another molecule of this functional group. Okay, so the ultimate word is that this hydroxyl can abstract this proton here to here. You may argue that, sir, this is nitrogen, this is more basic. Why it will have to accept? In equilibrium, protonated percentage of this species will be more. But here, if equilibrium protonation slight amount happen also, that will lead the reaction. And these steps are reversible. Ultimately, equilibrium will be shifted towards this side. That is the basic fundamental understanding. Fine. This. So, this lone pair can push and it can leave. So, ultimately, what will be produced? This is R, this is the hydrogen, this is the nitrogen, this is the O, SOO minus. Fine. And what can happen? See, this is already converted into a good living group like format there. So this will be abstracted, it will come and it will leave. So, and it is hydrogen stabilized by these two combination. So what is the product finally? RCN. Okay, one step. And so this is the overall discussion. Now we will discuss another little different type of strategy to prepare this nitrile. Actually, I think I should have been given you earlier, but I forgot. So let's give you the example. Example is that first step is hydroxylamine to hydrazine formation. Fine. So RCO. Sorry, let's write the hydrazine formation. So this is the hydrogen, this is the NHOH. Fine. I'm not going to see strong. So two possible. So if we provide acetic anhydride. Acetic anhydride means CH3COO. Here also CH3COO. Why I am writing twice? Because cis and trans, for example, this hydroxyl, this same side, opposite side. So let's focus on that two form. So what do I mean? So let's take the cis side. R, C, double bond, N, O. This is the cis derivative, I can say what? Same side. Better to say? Same side of the this proton as well as leaving. Right now, let's draw the trans. R C double bond N O C C O CH3. This, and we know anti could be done very easily. Why? Because if you think of another way also, it's a molecular orbital. So the sigma star of this bond is here, this. Sigma star of this bond, sorry, this bond is here. So this is the sigma star. So plus, minus, this is the sigma star. And the sigma of this CH is here. Actually, this is sp2 orbital. So as you can see, this is sp2. Fine. So what happens? If base abstract this proton, these two orbital can have a better overlap. So in this way the bond is constructed, and if it constructed it will leave. So from here we understand influence of actually acidic anhydride and heat is essential. Okay, slight heat is needed. So these will also result in nitrile. Fine. And here, but here the story is different. So how this will happen? It will happen a cyclic pathway. So means that this lone pair will start, but for better thing than writing this way, this, it will come this, it will come this. So in this way, through a cyclic transition state, it will result in RCN plus acetic acid. Here also, so some in medium who abstract this, this is the acetic anion. So this state acetic acid is produced and here acetate is leaving. So ultimately this will result the same thing. So this is the understanding point of view. Now I shall provide you two examples. Okay. So let's discuss the last one. Two problems. Okay. So first step, because this is benzaldehyde, in presence of hydroxylamine hydrochloride first step and neutralized with sodium hydroxide. This is little different compared to traditional method. So, if it is very strong base, then expected that it will remain as a sodium salt. This we got exactly fine C base. And actually, you should write here minus water. Dehydration. So, in next step, what happens? So, in presence of this CO, water, CO2 is purged. Why? Because to neutralize, this is the purpose is to neutralize. CO2 is acidic oxide. We are reacting an acidic oxide with a base, so neutralization will happen. And here what is produced? Sodium carbonate or bicarbonate, better to say bicarbonate. Sodium carbonate or bicarbonate. Fine, so in this way, so this is produced. So now, see, this is a scene, means this hydrogen and hydroxyl in the same direction. Now, it see its boiling point, a melting point is 35 compared to, if you see the anti one, this boiling point is 130 degree. Actually, I don't know the exact mechanism, but I have some my personal opinion, and that is, if you see the same one, this pH double bond NOH and this, so they may have, okay, so no, this is not a right logic. Okay, so this is not a good means melting point is not that much higher. Wrong understanding. So this, but when this is passed into an ether solution in acidic medium, is initially instantly converted into this. So how this is happening, I have one of my personal opinion. I am not sure about the answer. If you have any better logic, please share it in the comment box. So what is that logic? The logic is, if you see, this is actually a nitrogen, this is a phenyl. So if it is in antiposition, this is more stable. Okay, because conjugation. But so when it produced in O minus, it will prefer, because the dipole moment are in anti orientation. Fine, conjugation is better on anti orientation. But when you acidify this, what is expected? First is that it is OH. Fine, Second protonation is expected to happen on this, fine. So what can happen? So these will coordinate and this bond will open. So it will have a means free CC rotation. What do I mean? Let's consider this is a plus charge, this is deorganized in this way. This is the nitrogen, this is hydrogen, this is OH. Now this is a CC single bond right now. So rotation allowed. So in this way. Now question, when it is in alpha, this is produced and this is stabilized. Why? Because see, it is true that this is unstable. But in acidic medium it can form, and compared to these two, if this is formed, chances going to back is difficult. So that's why this is predominant. But if you think this is not a proper logic, please mention. And if you have any other better logic, please mention in the comment box. And I request other to encourage the person who try to provide some better explanation. It is not that I know everything. Majority of case, no, I know something little more, I believe, but it is true, it may be true that you know better than me. So please share your knowledge with me also, in this way both will be benefited. Fine? Okay. So now let's discuss the second problem. So this is a design substrate, just observe the substrate carefully. You can understand that this, the example, so this two condition are same substrate it's treated. And actually, ultimately resulted into two different products. Okay, why and how? This is the question. So we'll discuss now. So let's discuss the path one. So first is NaOH, second step H3O+. NaOH and heat. So what is expected that NaOH and heat? What it will do? So let's draw the substrate again. This is double bond NOH. From where this is obtained? So it was aldehyde. Okay, so this in place of this nitrogen there is an oxygen. So this is oxymos form. That is the retrosynthetic background. So this is O minus now. Fine. And this is chloride. And see, since heat is given, what happened? These will attack here. Why? This is actually a aromatic nucleophilic substitution. Fine. So it attacks over this, and if I draw the structure of nitro properly, this is plus, so it comes here, it comes here, it goes here. So in this way, what is the intermediate? This is the Cl, this is the oxygen, this is nitrogen, this is hydrogen, and this is O minus, the nitrogen is in plus. So in next step what happens? It pushes this and Cl leaves. Why? Because chlorine is a better leaving group. Another thing, there is a chance that it may leave, but ultimately result is nothing. So ultimately we are getting something else. So pathway is this one. So what it will result? It will result in, this is the NO2, this hydrogen in all this. So in this is the product. So this is this product. Fine. Now interesting part is the acetic anhydride one. So if you put acetic anhydride to this, what is expected? So acetylation will happen on here. So this OH will leap and NaOC will result. Let's clean it. So acetic anhydride Ac2O, and why sodium acetate? Because you know, when this reaction completes, it produces acetic acid. Okay, and since the medium is acidic, that's why another thing, in acidic medium this may hydrolyze. So that's why this, in order to maintain the pH, sodium acetate is added. Another thing, it's an acetic anhydride, it's a sodium acetate. So cross acetate formation is also not possible. So what happens? CH3COOAC. I am not writing this part. So this lone pair attacks at this center, opens, and pushes these leaves. So what it result? This is NO2, this is Cl, H, N, O, S. This fine. So in next step, see, there is NaOSC and sodium carbonate and heat. Actually, heat should be given. This is a base. So what happens? So now see, previously these H versus these NOH, they are anti. So right now, but OH was not a good living group, but because of this acetate formation, it became a good living group. So this carbonate base, so this base, that is the sodium carbonate, abstracts proton here, this, and it leaves. So ultimately product. So product is, this is NO2, this is the Cl, this is C, triple bond N. So see, changing the condition, how product is changed. That's why I called it as design substance. Everything is designed properly that, okay, if we place this group in this position, this activity could be achieved. Okay. So this is the overall discussion about Beckmann rearrangement and aldoxime form. Beckmann rearrangement using aldoxime, which results in nitrile. So this is the overall discussion. So we have learned a lot. What we have learned? We have learned first oxime formation. Second, why buffer is taken. Third, why, how anti-orientation happened, how it could be converted into leaving group. Okay, by the way, I missed, not only acid, means this OH conversion into leaving group, not only acid. I'll give you another example. So, not only acid, this example, for example, let's take R, this NOH, not only acid, even phosphorus trichloride or phosphorus pentachloride can also be used for this purpose. So what happens? So when these oxygen, actually this is not a good leaving group. So if it attached to phosphorus pentachloride, thionyl chloride, etc., then this is converted into a good leaving group. How? See, this is oxygen. For example, if you consider this thionyl chloride, this. So right now, if it leaves, means O minus, then it will come here. So it will in this way, it will be so stabilized. So sorry, I made wrote two thionyl, means thionyl should be this. So this, so in this way, it will result in sulfur dioxide, in case of phosphorus, ultimately that is also a similar means ultimately after work of phosphoric acid. So similarly, PFCl5, SOCl2, even Lewis acid mediated, this elimination is also possible. Please keep it in mind. So thank you everyone for listening. I know this is a big lecture, long lecture. So thank you for your patience. Stay happy, stay blessed. See you in my next video.